process to discuss about the, some problems on the condensation and how to take the, in the yesterday classes we discuss about the how to take that mean temperature, that's if it is surface temperature and if it is the saturation temperature of the steam is given and you have to take the average of it, that is called as a mean temperature. How to identify the condensation thickness of the condensate on the plate. So if it is a vertical plate, which formula you have to take from the data handbook, and how the properties are noted down, and which formula you have to take the, for the average heat transfer coefficient and local heat transfer coefficient, and how to calculate the mass of the condensate, and how to calculate the heat transfer rate in the yesterday we discussed that. So further we'll go, that is the some other numerical certainties, and if it is in the horizontal cases. So yesterday almost all the problem numericals, yesterday we saw that is called as the vertical plate. If it is in the horizontal, okay, then if it is in the bundle of tubes, okay, bundle of tubes on the condensation, what happened that one is, okay. Array, okay, this is a number of arrays there, horizontal and vertical arrays there. In that cases, how to get, okay. Suppose if the pressure is only given, okay, how to note down that one is the saturation temperature from the steam table also. Yesterday we discussed about that, okay. So this is the case we given that one is, and today we are going to discuss about the some numericals which are in the horizontal position. Okay, so we need to discuss about that one. If the pipe or plate, okay, it is a horizontal, so that means we need to discuss about that. Okay, here is the, I think, here this, there's some problem certainly, okay. Here, a tube of, okay, here a tube of 13 mm, a diameter in outer diameter, a tube of 13 mm in outer diameter and 1.5 meter long is used to condensate, understand, is used to condensate the steam at 40 kilopascal. So saturation temperature is equal to 76 degrees Celsius. Here in this problem, so the diameter of the tube is given and the long, how much length is that one is 1.5 meter they given, 40 kilopascal pressure is given, and also given that one is a saturation temperature 76 degrees Celsius. Okay, calculate the heat transfer coefficient H, okay, heat transfer for this tube. First one is in the horizontal portion and second one is in the vertical portion. So you need to calculate H. So both, if it is the tube is in the horizontal portion and vertical portion, this is a very important numerical certainty. Okay, you can come to know about in the both of portion. Take the average tube wall temperature as 52 degrees Celsius. Here, he directly given the a mean temperature. Understand? Take the average tube wall temperature as 52 degrees Celsius. He directly given that one is called as a mean temperature, 52 degrees Celsius, okay? So here 52 degrees Celsius go to 76. 76 saturation temperature is already given. Plus T surface is equal to 2. And so that one is the, what is that one is the? T surface temperature, that one is called as a, so 28 degrees. By this, you know, come to know by this value, you know, surface temperature is equal to 28 degrees Celsius. T saturation is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Diameter is given 0.013 meter, that one is, okay? 0.3, that is in meter. L is equal to 1.5 meter. So, we have to note down the properties of water. Understand? Properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius. Understand? Properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius. But in the data handbook, okay, in the data handbook, the properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius, you can't get. Okay, at that cases, so how to calculate? I will share that with the here. Wait for 1 minute. You are getting the screen here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Here, listen here. It is a data handbook, okay? So this one is a data handbook where we are getting the properties of water at 40 degrees Celsius. Understood? Okay? And properties of water at 60 degrees Celsius. But we want the properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius. Okay, how to calculate in this situation, that how to get the properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius. Understand? You are getting the second here, the screen, and you understood that means what I am telling?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, here the properties of water, okay? At 40 degrees Celsius you are getting, and at 60 degrees Celsius will you. But in, we are not getting the properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius. In that case, how to note down the properties of water at saturated state per 52 degrees Celsius. So for that one, we are going to use the interpolation formula, that one is. Understand? So here I will show that one is. So interpolation formula, that one is. So here, that one is. Okay. So are you getting the screen now? That one.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So 52 degrees Celsius. How to note down that one is, okay? See that data and book properties of water at 52 degrees Celsius is not available, but the properties can be obtained using the relation. What is that one is? X minus X1 divided by X2 minus X1, that is equal to Y minus Y1 divided by Y2 minus Y1. So this is called as the interpolation formula, that one is. What do you call that one is? Okay, means that one is temperature at 52 degrees Celsius, 52 temperature minus, this one is temperature 40. So temperature 60 minus temperature 40. Understand? Because why are you taking 60, 40? Because temperature, that one is 60 and 40. Understand? Okay, temperature. But we want the properties at 52 degrees Celsius. Understand? 52 minus 40, 60 minus 40. Means that is, we want the density at 52 degrees Celsius minus, so temperature at 40 degrees Celsius, temperature at 60 degrees Celsius, and density at 60 degrees Celsius and density at 40 degrees Celsius. So we need to calculate this one. So density at 52 degrees Celsius we want. So that is at 52 temperature. Okay. But we know that one is from the data and book which is available. Okay. Density at 40 degrees Celsius is that's 995 kg per meter cube. And density at 985. Okay. The density at 60 degrees Celsius is 985. Density at 40 degrees Celsius is 995. Correct. Okay. So from this one, you need to calculate. Then finally, that one is this formula you should know about, that one is. Understand? This is called as an interpolation formula. And density at, you substitute all these things, that one is. Only that one is density at 52 degrees Celsius. You come to know about, that one is. Density at 52 degrees Celsius is 985. kg per meter cube here. Understand? Okay. Oh, I think are understood this one is? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes. 52 temperature. We want to know about the density at 52 degrees Celsius. The 52 minus 40. Why are you taking 40? That's what is the properties we need to calculate in between 40 and 60 as per the data and book. 52 minus 40 divided by 60 minus 40. That is density at 52 we want, that is minus 995. This is the density at 40 degrees Celsius. So divided by density at 60 degrees Celsius minus density at 40 degrees Celsius. So you substitute all these things here from the data handbook and you need to calculate density at 52 degrees Celsius. So lastly, you come to know what that is. What is the density at 52 degrees Celsius? 989 kg per meter cube. Okay. So this is the interpolation formula, that one is. Okay. Similarly, for all the properties, understand, same thing. So using that one is density at 52 so degree mean temperature, so that's one is 989 kg per meter cube. Similarly for the thermal conductivity, understand thermal conductivity, that's one is thermal conductivity, what temperature? 52 degree Celsius temperature. And you note down the temperature, thermal conductivity at 40 degrees Celsius from the data and look, that is 0.6280. Thermal conductivity at 60 degrees Celsius, 0.6513. So thermal conductivity at 40 degrees is 0.6280. That's 52 minus 40, 60 minus 40, that is 12 divided by 20. Already you note down that here. Okay. Then substitute all these things. We will get the thermal conductivity is at 52 degrees Celsius, 0.6419 watt per meter Kelvin. So you need to kinematic viscosity, because dynamic viscosity from the data and book is not available directly. First, you need to calculate the kinematic viscosity. So at 52 degrees Celsius, using the same relations, again, you need to calculate the what is called as kinematic viscosity. So kinematic viscosity is finally, you will get that one is a kinematic viscosity is 0.4496 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square per second here. Okay. So then using this relation, okay, this is a relation. Using this relation, mu is equal to dynamic viscosity is equal to kinematic viscosity into density. Okay. Density is also noted down 989 kg per meter cube. Kinematic viscosity, that one is already noted at 52 degrees Celsius. Then dynamic viscosity is equal to 0.000543 Newton second per meter square. Okay, you will get that one is okay. But so you note down all the properties. Okay, but HFG you have to note down. HFG at saturation temperature only you have to note down directly. HFG at saturation temperature 76 degrees Celsius is given. Okay, that is so that one is 2318.1 kilojoules per kg. Okay, 2318.1 into 10 raised to 3 joules per kg. So that is HFG at 76 degrees Celsius. Okay, then first one is horizontal portion. Understand, for horizontal portion from the data handbook, average heat transfer coefficient. This is the formula from the data handbook. For the horizontal portion, till yesterday, that means we are calculating that is a heat transfer coefficient only for the vertical. So we are not calculated that, so that means the for the horizontal. Understand? Okay. We are not solved that is for the horizontal. Today we are solving that is from the data and book, which is a horizontal portion that is okay. The problem which is horizontal portion from the data and book for the average heat transfer coefficient for the horizontal portion of the pipe is at least H is equal to 0.725 into rho L density of the liquid into density of the liquid minus density of the vapor into KQ G. Okay. So into H of G divided by mu L dynamic viscosity TV minus TS into D. You have to note down here D. If it is in the horizontal portion, D will come. If it is in the original portion, L will come. Okay, vertical portion, L will come. But we are solving this one is a numerical, which is in the horizontal portion. The diameter will be up here instead of the L here. Okay, raised to 1 upon 4 here. Understand? So, as you know, that one is rho v is less than rho L. Okay, rho v is 0.5. Okay, so we should not consider because it is very, very less as compared to the rho L density of the liquid. Okay, that cases we have to take rho v as a zero here, then it becomes rho L square. H is equal to 0.725 rho L square K cube G into H of G. Okay, 1 upon 4. Mu L TV minus TS. TV is called as the saturation temperature or vapor temperature. That is called as 76 degrees Celsius. Understand? Minus TS here, that one, into D here. If it is a horizontal portion, you have to take D here and you have to substitute whatever that one is the noted that one is that properties at 52 degrees Celsius you have to substitute all these things here, that one is, okay? Here that is 76 minus 28. We calculated the surface temperature of the tube here, that is 28 degrees Celsius. That's when its D is 0.013 meter, okay? It is a mu value, and it's a HFG, it should be in the joules, okay? It should be in the joules here, okay? Into 10 raised to 3 is given. Calculate, substitute all these things, then, okay, you will get that one is the, what is the value of this one is the horizontal portion, that is a heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient is equal to 8321.774 watt per meter square degree Celsius, watt per meter square degree Celsius, okay? So solve this one is, and if any doubt, you can ask me that, okay? So H is equal to 8321.774 watt per meter square degree Celsius, okay? This is for the horizontal position. This is for the horizontal position. For vertical, average heat transfer coefficient from the data book, that's the formula you'll be changing. This is H is equal to 0.943. Here it is 0.725 for the horizontal. For vertical, that's one is the 0.943. Okay? For the average heat transfer coefficient, for the vertical, here the L will come. Understand? Here the L will come. But for the horizontal, here the D will come. Remember that one is. Understand? So this one here, that you have to note down. For the average, for vertical, average heat transfer coefficient, the formula is H is equal to 0.943 K cube rho square G H of G. So mu L into TV minus TS here, rest to 1 upon 4, 0.943. Substitute all the datas here. Substitute all the datas here. That means you will get that one is the, what is called as for the vertical plate, H is equal to 3302.5 watt per meter square degree Celsius, that is. Okay. Here, you compare here, average heat transfer coefficient for the vertical is less than the horizontal. Understand? Less than the horizontal. Okay. Because that one is, whenever the flow occurs, if the pipe is horizontal, it flows along the length of the pipe. Understand? Hence, in the horizontal portion, the heat transfer coefficient will be more as compared to in the vertical portion. It is a very, very good thing. So good. Okay, that one is the, means you should know about that one. Heat transfer coefficient for the, so that one is the, heat transfer is, that one is much, whenever it is in the horizontal portion, as compared to the vertical portion, that one is. Because that means if it is a horizontal, heat passes, that one, whatever that one is, it is along the length of the pipe. Along the length of the pipe, that one is, the flow will be, flow is from one side to the other side. Understand? If the flow is from one side to the other side, then hence it is called as the here. Yes. If it is the horizontal, okay, the flow will be from here. Flow here along the complete length of the pipe. Hence, in this case, that one is the heat transfer coefficient will be a more in the horizontal. Okay. If it is in the length, okay, it will be flow along this side only. Understand? Along this side. Okay. We are considered for the entire length. But length is in the denominator part. Understand? As per the numerical certain is. Okay? Hence, in this case, certain is the, what is called as the heat transfer coefficient is very, very less in the vertical surfaces. Okay? So, this is the things we need to consider here. Okay? Next. Okay? Do you have any doubt here? So, I think how to solve that one is in the numericals in the horizontal portion and vertical portion. So you have to come to know what that means. Okay. So next, what is the next type of the formula we need to? So numericals we need to consider here. Here. Yeah. Yeah, next one. Find the Nusselt heat transfer coefficient. Find the Nusselt heat transfer coefficient and mass condensate. Mass condensate. Understand? Per hour, if the vertical square plate of 40 centimeters, square plate 40 into 40 centimeter into 40 centimeter, okay, is exposed to steam at atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means saturation temperature of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. You come to know what that one is. Okay. The plate is maintained at uniform temperature. Plate is maintained at uniform temperature of 96 degrees Celsius. Understand? Plate is maintained at uniform temperature of 96 degrees Celsius. Okay. So you have to Nusselt. Nusselt means that one is the whatever that one is the heat transfer coefficient equation H and thickness, the condensate thickness that is derived by the scientist Nusselt. Okay. So that's why he asked that one is the Nusselt heat transfer coefficient that one is and mass condensate that one is. What you need to calculate for the mass condensate? First you need to calculate the H, then you have to calculate the Q heat transfer rate. Then using the HFG, you need to calculate the mass condensate here per hour. Of the vertical, what is the portion of the plate here? Vertical, okay. Vertical square means that one is length is given, that one is the 40 centimeter. You have to convert that one into the meter, that is called as a 0.4 meter. Length is called as a 0.4 meter. Is exposed to steam at atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means that when the saturation temperature of the water is that is called as 100 degrees Celsius. The plate is maintained at a uniform temperature. The surface temperature of the plate is given 96 degrees Celsius. Then first one thing is you have to note down the what is the mean temperature. That is 96 plus what is that one is the plate is vertical, okay? Atmospheric, that one is the 100 degrees Celsius. TB is called as a 100 degrees Celsius, TS is called as a 96 degrees Celsius, and A area is equal to 0.45 because of this one is a square, okay? So 0.4 into 0.4, 0.16 meter square, okay? Means TB minus TS, that one is called as a 100 minus 96 is equal to 4 degrees Celsius. You can also note down here. The mean temperature, okay? Mean temperature is that one is the 100 plus 96 divided by 2. So 196 divided by 2, that is correct. Mean temperature is called as a 98 degrees Celsius, okay? Okay, next one is this 98 degrees Celsius, okay? The properties of these things, we have to take at this 98 degrees Celsius. But properties of water are not available at 98 degrees Celsius as we discussed in the previous numericals. For that reason, we have to consider the interpolation, that one is formula x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. So equal to y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1. You have to consider this formula, that one is. Understand? Then, so you have to note down the all these properties at 98 degrees Celsius. Okay. So I calculated the each and everything here. That one is. So that one is the first one is the, but at 98 is not obtained directly from the book. Okay. So properties at 80 degrees Celsius and properties at 100 degrees Celsius can be obtained, and properties at 98 degrees Celsius can be obtained using the following relation, x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1, that is equal to y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1. Okay, temperature interpolation formula, that one is. Okay, first using this relation, I calculated the thermal conductivity here. Okay, thermal conductivity at 98 degrees Celsius. Okay, the thermal conductivity at 98 degrees Celsius, that is called as a 0.6792, I got that one is. Understand? Okay. So you can calculate and you can get that one is the thermal conductivity at 98, that is 0.6792 watt per meter Kelvin here, that one is. Understand? Similarly, for the density also, density also you can note down that one is from using the interpolation formula. That's similarly for the density also, the what do you get that at 98 degrees Celsius, that is rho density 98 is equal to 98 degrees Celsius is equal to 962.3 so kg per meter cube, you will get that one is okay. Then similarly, using the interpolation formula, that one is the kinematic viscosity, I got that one is the, so kinematic viscosity 98 degrees Celsius at 98 degrees Celsius temperature of the mean temperature 0.3001 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay, so that's in meter square per second. This one is SI unit is meter square per second. You got that one is from this using the kinematic viscosity and density here. We can calculate the dynamic viscosity using the relations that one is dynamic. So dynamic viscosity of the water at saturation temperature. So that one is at 98 degrees Celsius is also kinematic viscosity 98 at 98 degrees Celsius into density. The you will get that one is the dynamic viscosity is equal to 0.0002887. So that one is the Newton second per meter square. You will get that one. So this is called as the dynamic viscosity at 98 degrees Celsius of mean temperature. Okay, so you all these properties you can get using the interpolation formula. That one is okay. Nusselt heat transfer coefficient for the vertical plate, that one is cut as an average. Okay, vertical plate, he asked that one is the vertical. Okay, so average heat transfer coefficient H is equal to, that one is wiki. So you know that one is a note down the formula from the data handbook here. H is equal to 0.943, so KQ rho square G HFG divided by mu L. Why are you taking the L here? Because of this one is the vertical. Understand? So because of this one is the vertical into TV minus TS raised to 1 upon 4. Substitute the whatever the properties we are noted down, that one is the calculated at 98 degrees Celsius in this formula. And so you have to come to know. This HFG should be in the joules. Once again, I'm telling that one is this HFG should be in the joules. Okay. Then H is equal to 0.943. Okay. H is equal to 0.943. So this one is the, what is the K value? K cube here, that one is. And what is the rho square density square here? And all this you have to note down here. And finally, you will get the answer. H is equal to 10240.4769. Watt per meter square degree Celsius here. Okay, so this is for the what is called as a vertical plate, that means the so heat transfer coefficient. This is called as a Nusselt heat transfer coefficient, that means H is equal to 10,240.47. okay, 69 watt per meter square degree Celsius. That is called as a heat transfer coefficient. But we need to calculate the mass of the condensate. Understand? Heat transfer, that's Q is equal to HA TV minus TS. Understand? So this is called as the average heat transfer coefficient, H here, that one is. So Q already calculated. You have to note down what is the area. Area is, this is a square one, square plate. 0.4 into 0.4. Okay? So TV is 100 degrees Celsius, saturation temperature of the water. TS, surface temperature is all given 96 degrees Celsius. So you will get that one is HFG is equal to 6,553.90 watt. You will get that one is. Okay. Then we need to calculate the mass of the condensate. Okay. We need to calculate the mass of the condensate. M dot is equal to Q divided by HFG. Understand? Q divided by HFG here. That's 6,553. Already Q is calculated. You have to take this one is Q. And HFG, that's in the joules, okay? 2257 into 10 raised to 3 joules here. You will get that one is the mass of the condensate is 0.00290 kg per second. You will get that one is. Understand? Okay? Then we should be convert that one into the kg per hour, okay? Multiply 3600 to this equation. You will get the mass of the condensate is equal to 10.453 kg per hour. Understand? Okay. So this is the how to calculate the what is called as the mass of the condensate and mass of heat transfer rate and heat transfer coefficient for the vertical plate. So that one. Okay. Next. So in the next numericals will be very different. That one is okay. So we'll solve the other numericals. That one is okay. Steam at 0.065 bar condenses on a vertical plate. Again, he considered that one is the vertical plate. Steam at 0.065 bar. So condenses on a vertical plate of 0.6 meter square. Okay. This is also square. If the surface temperature of the plate is maintained at 15 degrees Celsius. Here the surface temperature is given, that one is the 15 degrees Celsius. Estimate the rate of condensation, mass flow rate, okay, mass of the condensation. And surface saturation temperature, TS is given, that one is the saturation temperature, 37.7 degrees Celsius. And HFG at 0.06 by bar is also given the HFG, okay. Then 2412 × 10³ joules per kg. And properties of water at mean temperature of 26.4 degrees Celsius was that, because here the average temperature, mean temperature is also given in this problem. Understand, mean temperature is also given 26.4 degrees Celsius. What is the mean temperature? 37.7 plus 15 degrees Celsius divided by 2, you will get this temperature. 26.4 degrees Celsius are listed below here. What is the properties are here listed below? He given the properties at mean temperature. He given the mean temperature also. He given that one is a HFG also. He given the saturation temperature of the steam also given. And surface temperature is also given, that one is. Just we need, that one is the square plate, that one is the dimensions also he given, that one is. Just you need to estimate the rate of condensation, mass flow rate you need to calculate. What is the portion of the plate here? Vertical portion. Vertical portion, that one is a, what is the need for that one is. So you need to calculate that one, okay? Here, that one is the diagram here, 0.6 meter here. This is the steam here, that one is there. What is the surface temperature, saturation temperature of the steam? 37.7 degrees Celsius. And this one is the surface temperature is the 15 degrees Celsius. Then TV minus TS is equal to 37.7 minus 15, 22.7 degrees Celsius. That one is, you can get that one is, okay? Okay, then HFG is also given. Okay, HFG is also given here. So that one is HFG is equal to 2412 × 10³ joules per kg. Okay, he also given average heat transfer coefficient for the vertical plate. Already you know this formula, so you have to take, that one is from the data handbook. So H is equal to 0.943 K cube rho square into G into HFG divided by mu L into TV minus TS raised to 1/4. So we are taking the L here because of the, this one is called as the vertical plate here. Okay. You have to note down the all the properties which are given in the statement of the problem. Okay. 0.943. So that one is, you have to note down all here, that one is, then you will get that one is the, what is the H is equal to, after noting down and calculating that one is the, you will get that one is the, what is called as, 5897.984 watt per meter square here, that one. But here TV minus TS is equal to, that one is the 22.7 degrees Celsius. Is it right? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 22.7 degrees Celsius. So you can take here the TV minus TS is equal to 22.7 degrees Celsius. Okay. So that one is the, note down all the things, you can calculate perfectly, that one is. H is equal to 5897.984 watt per meter square degree Celsius. You will get that one. Okay. So after that, calculating of the H, average heat transfer coefficient, then you have to calculate the heat transfer rate. What is the equation for the heat transfer rate? That is H into A into TV minus TS here. Understand? TV minus TS here. That's Q is equal to 5897. Okay, you take that sentence 5897, 0.984 also you can take into points. Area is 0.6 into 0.6. Okay, into TV minus TS is already not on that one, 22.7 degrees Celsius. Okay, then heat transfer rate is 48,198.33 watt. You will get that one is. Understand? So Q is equal to 48,198.33 watt. You will get that one is. Then mass of the condensate or rate of condensation is equal to Q divided by HFG. Okay, that's 48,198.33. The HFG is directly given. So 2412 into 10 raised to 3. That's one is called as. So 0.0199 kg per second. You will get that one is. Okay, then. So you have to convert that one into the kg per hour. So we have to multiply 3600 per the given answer here. 0.2 to the 0.0199 here. You will get that one is 71.9257 kg per hour. You will get that one. Or that's equal to 72 kg per hour. That one is. Okay. So this is the how to calculate the mass of the condensation here. That one is. Okay. Then. We'll solve the next problem. So this is entirely different here. Okay. So this one is the here the term is the array hey given. Okay. How if they given in the array? That's a matrix. Okay. So horizontal this pipes, vertical this amount, this this amount, that's one is the number of pipes and horizontal this amount. In that case, how to calculate the condensation, how to happen that one is how to calculate the mass of condensation, how to calculate the what is called as the heat transfer coefficient, how to calculate the heat transfer rate, that is you should do. This is a very important okay. So here, so air pre saturated steam at 85 degrees Celsius, saturation steam, that means 85 saturation temperature is 85 degrees Celsius, and pressure of that one is called as a 57.8 kilopascal. Okay, pressure is also given. Understand? Pressure is also given. Condenses on the outer surface of 225 horizontal tube. The number of tubes is horizontal tubes is that one is the 225. Understand? 225 horizontal tubes of 1.27 centimeter. Okay? So that one is the horizontal tube of 1.27 centimeter outside diameter. The diameter is 1.27 centimeter. Each pipe having a 1.27 centimeter outside diameter. Number of pipes is 225. Arranged in 15 into 50 array. Understand? 15 into 50 means that one is 15 horizontal, 15 vertical. 15 into 15 is equal to 225. I am right? Yes? Yes, 15 into 15 array. The tube surfaces are maintained at uniform temperature of 75 degrees Celsius. Means that one is surface temperature is 75 degrees Celsius here. So saturation temperature of the steam is given 85 degrees Celsius. Surface temperature of the east tube, that one is given 75 degrees Celsius. Calculate the total condensation rate. Total condensation rate per 225 pipes, you need to calculate per meter length of the tube, per meter length of the tube bundle, because the length of the tube is not given here. Understand? Length of the tube is not given, only diameter is given. Per meter length of the tube, you need to calculate that one is. What is called as the condensation rate per meter length of the tube, that one is. Okay? Here, suppose that one is the array. Here the horizontal 15 and vertical 15, that one is. Then how to calculate the what is called as the a mass of the condensation here in the, okay. So this type of the examples, okay. Suppose in the heat exchanger or that one is the, what is that, a condenser or any pipe, that one is, if you design that one is the, okay, air conditioner system, number of the industrial, this types of problems are mainly useful for the industrial applications, certainly. If the number of pipes are more, in that cases, how to calculate that one is the condensation, or that one is in that cases it will be useful. Okay, Ri is 15 into 15, 225. TV is equal to that one is the saturation temperature. Okay, or vapor temperature of the steam, that is 85 degrees Celsius. Pressure is given 57.8 kilopascal. Okay, so number of tubes 225. That one is the diameter is given. That one is the diameter of the each tube is 1.27 centimeter. So that one is 0.0127 meter. You can convert that one into the meter. So TS is 75. Surface temperature of the tube is 75 degrees Celsius. Then we need to calculate what we need to calculate. The mass of the condensation we need to calculate. First we note down that one is mean temperature. Understand what is the mean temperature? 85 plus 75 divided by 2. So saturation temperature of the steam or plus the surface temperature of the plate, or that is the 2 divided by 2, that is called as a mean temperature, that is 80 degrees Celsius. So properties of the, what is called as the steam or properties of the water at saturation, okay? So you have to note down at 80 degrees Celsius. So directly you can get from the data handbook, but it's because of that one is the properties of the water at saturation temperature at 80 degrees Celsius, you can get directly. So rho, K, mu, L, and gamma. So that one is the kinematic viscosity. You have to note down from the data handbook. Okay. HFG at 85 degrees Celsius, you are note down that one is 2295.3 from the steam tables. Understand? HFG at, so 85 degrees Celsius, 2295.3 from the steam table, you can note down that one. For the bank of tubes, calculation of H will be from the data handbook, it will be different that one is. Okay? For the bank of, in the data handbook, you written that one is the data handbook, HMT data handbook. For the bank of tubes, H can be calculated using this equation, that is 0.728 K cube rho square G into H of G divided by mu L N. N is called as a number of horizontal rows. How many of number of horizontal rows here? Yes?
15.
15. Okay. Number of horizontal rows is 15 because of this one is 15 into 50 Ri into D. Into D. What is the horizontal of the diameter of the pipe here? Sorry. Diameter of the pipe here. That one is called as 0.0127. Correct. Okay. Into TV minus TS here. That one is. Okay. N. You have to be careful. If it is, that one is the Ri is given. Okay, number of pipes is given. So you have to note down this formula from the data handbook. And so you have to, what is the N? Number of horizontal rows clearly indicate. Okay, number of horizontal rows place one above the one. That one is called as a N is equal to 15. Okay, you have to substitute that one is N value, that is 15 in this equation. And out of the properties of water at saturation temperature, you have to substitute here. Then you have to calculate here, that one is 0.6687, that one is called as a K, and density values and G values and HFG values. It is, should be in the joules, and that one is the mu values, N value and diameter, D value and 85 minus 75 raised to 1 upon 4. Then substitute. You will get that one is H is equal to 711, okay, 9.20 watt per meter squared degree Celsius. You will get that one is, okay. So using this H values, you can calculate the, what is the Q value here? Q value is equal to H into A TV minus T. Yes, that is equal to, that's one. But here diameter is going, okay. What is the A here? A is, if it is a tube is there, a surface area is pi dl, correct? Okay, yes, so sir. Pi dl, okay? Q is equal to H into A is called as a pi dl. So, but what you need to calculate, we told to calculate that one is heat transfer per unit length. Understand? That's Q divided by L. You have to take this side in the LHS side. That is equal to H into pi into D. TV minus TS, then finally you'll get Q divided by L is equal to 2840.43 watt per meter. Understand? This is only per one pipe. Remember that one is, but number of pipes is 225 tubes. Okay, 225 tubes. Q divided by L is equal to 225 into 28040.43 here. Then total for the 225 pipes, okay, the heat transfer per unit length is 639,097.77 watt per meter. Okay, this is for the 25 pipes. Okay, so almost all the students, what the mistakes you will do, they will take directly into the calculations of the further mass condensation. Understand? But you should not do. This is whatever the Q divided by L you are calculated only per the one pipe, but the number of pipes is 225 here. Then we need to calculate the heat transfer per unit length for the 225 pipe or tubes here, that one is. Understand? Then mass of the condensate is equal to Q divided by HFG, that is equal to 639097.77. What you calculated, 2295. HFG value is 2295 into 0.3 into 10 raised to 3. So this one is mass of the condensate per 225 pipe. Understand? For the 225 pipe is 1002.37 kg per hour meter. Okay? Why it is meter? Because per unit length. Understand? Per unit length. Kg per hour meter here. That's what is mass of the condensate. So this is the value here. That one is. Understand? Okay? Next. So this is the when they given, that one is the RI. Okay? Number of horizontal pipes and the number of the vertical pipes. In that cases, how to calculate, that one is here the numerical set. Okay? So here, this is a one type. This is a simple one. And so we'll solve this one also, and we'll end up today process that one. Here, a vertical tube taking experimental values of 60 mm OD and 1.2 meter long. The diameter is also given and length is also given. Is exposed to steam. Understand? Is exposed to steam at atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means that one is the saturation temperature of the water is called as the 100 degrees Celsius. And okay, the outer surface of the tube is maintained at a temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. Understand? Here, saturation temperature of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. Surface temperature of the tube is called as a 50 degrees Celsius by circulating the cold water through the tubes. Cold water through the tubes here. Calculate the rate of heat transfer Q. Okay, you can calculate to the coolant. Second one is called as a rate of condensation of the steam. Rate of condensation of the steam, you need to mass flow rate. Okay, mass of the condensation. Okay, mass of the condensation you need to calculate. Okay, so that one is the assume that film is laminar. Okay, that one is the assume that one is film is laminar, and he given the properties of water at 75 degrees Celsius also. Okay, what is the average temperature, mean temperature? 100 plus 50 divided by 2. That is called as a 75 degrees Celsius. Okay, in the statement of the problem, he given that one is the properties at 75 degrees Celsius. The 75 degrees Celsius is called as a mean temperature here. Understand? So he given the all the properties here. Okay, then properties of saturated vapor. Here, in this case, the properties of the saturated vapor, T saturation is 100 degrees Celsius. Rho V is also given, 0.96. If you given that one is, you can also take Rho V into consideration to the problem. Or you may not, okay, that one is, that is a question thing, okay? So, better to, so take into the account Rho V in the calculations, okay? And HFG is also given 2257 into 10 raised to 3 joules per kg get on at 100 degrees Celsius, okay? So then, vertical tube. Diameter, what is the diameter? 0.06 meter. Okay, what is the L here? 1.2 meter here. Yes, surface temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. Saturation temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. TU minus TS is equal to 50 degrees Celsius. Correct? Then Q, you need to calculate. M dot mass of the condensation is you need to calculate. Rho L is given, K is given, mu L is given, rho V is given, HFG is given in the statement. Okay, you need to calculate. Heat transfer. How to calculate for the vertical, that one is the heat transfer for the vertical plate here, that one is. So you have to note down this formula from the data handbook. 0.943 K cube HFG rho square into G divided by mu L into TV minus TS raised to 4. Substitute all these things in the data. Okay, so this is in the formula, that one is from the what you note down, that one is that's H is equal to. So you get here, I didn't take that one is the rho V value, but you can take, okay, because he is given in the statement of the problem, but here I neglected, okay. So you can take also for the calculations, okay, rho V is less than, I took that one is rho V is less than rho L, we can neglect, okay. The rho V is density of the vapor, okay. Then finally, we will get that one is the H value is called as 3862.10 watt per meter square degree Celsius. You will get that one is, understand, okay. H bar is equal to, this is the average heat transfer coefficient for the, what is that one is the vertical to, that one is called as a H is equal to 3862.10 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Then we need to calculate the mass of the condensate. For that one, we need to calculate the Q heat transfer rate. That is equal to H bar into A into TV minus TS here, that one is. That's Q is equal to 43,679.432 watt. Okay, 432 watt here, that one is. Okay, what is the area here? How to calculate the area here? Pi DL, pi correct? Pi DL, understand? Pi DL, how the D is given, L is given, understand? Pi DL, surface area you need to take here, okay? So the pi DL you need to calculate, then the Q value you will get here. Then mass of the condensate is equal to Q divided by HFG, that is equal to, so taking the value of the Q here and taking the value of the HFG here, then mass of the condensate 0.0193 kg per second. If it is in the kg per hour, mass of the condensate is equal to 69.67.